here in Milwaukee. We've got baseball on the show. The Atlanta Braves and the Milwaukee Brewers. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Okay, all set to go. And here's the veteran outfielder, Eddie Rosario.
Here we go, guys. Come on.
So now 1-2.
1-2.
And a pitch. And a swing and a miss. One gone here. Here is Ozzie Albies up to hit. And a pitch. That one missed. The 3-1. And fouled off. Here's a high chopper. Throw over to Telez, and Albies is retired. Here is Matt Olson.
The first baseman, Matt Olson.
Next pitch is outside, and that's ball two. At the belt and fires. Foul ball. No score, just getting started. Top of the first. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that is that. Bottom of the first. Here's the veteran second baseman, Colton Wong. Next pitch misses. 3-1. Left-hand hitter waits.
Well, it looks like he's wanting to work the upper part of the strike zone. What does that mean? Top hand better be working for the hitters. Adjust that side a little bit. Give yourself a chance to hit. What a battle. It's not always easy laying off a 3-2 pitch. And I tell you what, he earned that walk.
Willie Adames stands in. And the pitch. Bottom of the zone and a called strike. Runner at first with no outs here. Next pitch downstairs, and the count is even, 2-2. And that's downstairs and outside. On the ground, a second, might be two. Over to Swanson, he turns it. Plenty of time at first, that's a double play. Here's Yelich at the dish. The pitch. And a count 1-2. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. And that one fouled off.
I want to start that load a little bit sooner because of the good velo.
Swing and a miss, and he got him. Out number three. Back here at American Family Field, here's Marcell Ozuna. That one fouled off. Riding to the plate. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And he deals. stays alive. Got him. Leadoff man retired here in the second. Here's Austin Riley. Next offering is in for a strike. Second inning here, no score. And down on strikes he goes, two away now. Adam Duvall at the plate.
The center fielder, number 14, Adam Duvall.
Is a 1-1. Hammered down the line, could be extra bases. Around first, heading for two. Adamas, relay to second, not in time, it's a double.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Against good pitchers, you've got to take advantage of the mistakes. That was right in his wheelhouse, and he didn't miss a stitch.
Dansby Swanson stands in. Swinging a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. So now two on and two outs.
Now a great back and forth in that at bat. He had to lay off some really close pitches, and somehow Boogie found a way to keep the bat on his shoulder right there. I'll tell you right now, I couldn't have done it.
Now it's Alex Dickerson. Hard hit left side, and that one finds its way through. The throw is offline, and he's in to score, and it's 1-0.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. He wasn't able to elevate it, but he put a great swing on it right on time. Good balanced approach and just blasted it through the infield.
Strike two. Burns, one of the best strikeout pitchers in the game, and that certainly is a benefit to him when he's in a spot like this. The next pitch misses. Two balls, two strikes.
Yeah, if you're going to be in the game in high leverage situations, you've got to be able to get the swing and miss and put hitters away.
Slice down the right side. Righty delivers. Lifted in the air, right field. Drops into the glove, and that's the third out. Bottom half of inning number two. Now at the plate, Andrew McCutchen. Freed, he gets a lot of swing and miss, and he keeps the ball in the yard, not to mention the fact not too many hits either. Next one is off the plate, and now 3-1. Even some of the best guys in the sport are going to give up home runs from time to time, and he's an exception.
Yeah, and even with those home runs, if you're throwing strikes and keeping base runners off the paths, then those home runs are solo shots. But to this point, he hasn't had to worry about it.
And now it's Rowdy Tellez. Swing and a miss. 1-2. You look at what the elite guys do. They strike guys out, they limit walks, and they limit the ball going out of the park. McCutchen gets his lead at first with nobody out. Next offering misses, and the count is 2-2.
Yeah, all you want is a guy like that. Take the ball every fifth day, go out there, hand it over to the bullpen, perhaps in the seventh inning or later.
On the ground a second, might be two. Over to Swanson, he turns it. On to Olson, that's two. Hunter Renfro at the plate.
The right fielder, Hunter Renfro.
And a swing and a miss, and that's that. Back
back here at the ballpark, top half of the third inning. Now in for the Braves, Eddie Rosario. Right-hander kicks, deals. That one pushed to the left and foul.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
The 1-2. That one pushed foul. Kicks and fires. That misses the zone. The count now 2-2. The pitch. Little chopper rolls foul. And the righty deals. That just misses. Full count 3-2. And the right-hander deals. And there's ball four.
Well, that's a nice job of grinding out that at bat. Saw a lot of pitches and ends up drawing the walk. Very gritty.
Ozzie Albies up to the plate. Nobody out. Runner at first. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Here comes a pitch. And a foul ball. And that one wrapped foul. The 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. Left-hand batter waits. Stays alive. Hit hard. Should be extra bases. And that's going to get into the corner. Throw comes in. Runner stopped. Second and third. Nobody out. And now it's Matt Olson's turn to hit. Next one misses. And a count 2-1. The pitch. On the ground to third. Brasso tosses to first. And Olson is set down. Marcell Ozuna next up for the Braves. He was a strikeout victim his first time. Two on, one out. Got him. Two away. Austin Riley next up for the Braves.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Towards first, base hit, one run is in. Not in time, he's safe.
Well done, drives in the run. I know that was a ground ball, but it was absolutely hammered through the infield. That's not one you're excited to get in front of if you're an infielder. You know they used to say, charge it. Crazy.
And now Adam Duvall. Next pitch is outside. Two outs. To third, Brasso handles. That ends the inning, and they limit the damage. Welcome back. Set for the bottom of the third. Omar Narvaez at the plate. The 1-1. Swings through that one.
Now there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Now it's Lorenzo Cain. Swings and misses. It's a ball and two strikes. And the pitch. And that one missing low. Why to kick the pitch? Got him looking. That's the second out. Now batting Michael Brasso. Ball and a strike. Way high. 2-2 down. Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. D'Arnaud on to first, and it's in time for the third out, so that'll end the inning. On to the fourth. So now to the plate for Atlanta, Dansby Swanson. Swing and a miss, and it's one and two.
He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
Down to the dirt, swing and a miss. In time to get him, one away in the strikeout.
Well, maybe approaching this at bat with a bit too much determination. Sometimes you just got to let the game come to you.
Swing, and this is ripped down the right field line. Way back there. Here. He made him pay for that one, and they boost their lead. It's 3-0.
Well, he really crushed that thing down the line, and everyone had to hold their breath until it clanked off the pole. And every time that happens, it just kind of feels like a trick shot or something, but really, it's just a stroke of luck that it stays fair long enough.
And now it's Travis D'Arnaud at the plate. Next offering is in for a strike. Bounce to Narvaez. Throws to first. Play is made. Two out. Back to the leadoff spot in the Braves lineup. Here's Eddie Rosario. Kicks and deals. That one drifts inside. Two down, nobody on. Hit on the ground to the right side. Wong picks it up on the run, sends it over to first, and that is that. Ready to go, bottom four. Here's the leadoff man for the Brewers, Colton Wong. The lefty ready, and a 1-1. Swings through that one for strike two. And now it's 1-2. Comes up empty as he chases that one in the dirt. Throw to first. Gets him. One away on a drop third strike.
Just not a good pitch to swing at. One reason he's an everyday player is he usually lays off of that junk.
Now here is Willie Adames. He hit into a double play his first time up. Line drive caught. Now it's Christian Yelich. Next offering is foul back. Fought off foul.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the bat alive.
Foul back our way, and that's out of play.
Also really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball.
Five foul balls in a row. I have no idea what that feels like, but you got to love this battle. Just wondering who's going to blink first.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Freed throws the first. Throw is low, and he can't pick it. Yelich, the runner at first with two gone. The next offering misses, and it's 2-1. The pitch. Late with the swing there.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
And here it comes. And it's filled up.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
That's ripped. Base hit. They stopped the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs. Here's Rowdy Tellez. And that'll load the bases.
Now that sets up a really big at bat in this game. These are the moments when everyone in the stadium gets really locked in.
So two down now, and here is Hunter Renfro. 0-for-1, he struck out swinging last time. That is ball four, and that'll bring home a run.
He's really gotten himself into a mess out there and now forces home a run with the wall. This inning's definitely getting away from him. Yeah, I'm surprised we didn't see a visit from the pitching coach here. Just to remind him, focus on the hitter. Don't worry about anything else.
And a foul ball. He stays alive. Next offering is way upstairs. Just misses there. So all three runners will be off with a full count pitch with two away.
Yeah, this is a good chance to tie this ball game up. Maybe even take the lead if they can get something deep into the gap in the outfield.
No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And that is the inning. Back here in Milwaukee, now Ozzie Albies. And a pitch stays alive. At the belt and fires. And a swing and a miss. Down on strikes. One away. Here's Matt Olson. One down, base is empty. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. Out number two. Now the Atlanta cleanup hitter, Marcell Ozuna.
This is important. If he can go 1-2-3 here, will be a very positive sign for him and for his team.
Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. And makes the play, and that's out number three. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's a speed threat, Lorenzo Cain. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. And it beats him for the first out after the drop third strike. Next for the Brewers, Michael Brasso. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Gosh, another walk in this one. Man, he is having some real issues with control.
Colton Wong up to hit. And now the lefty on the ground out to short. Nice stop. Over to Albies. Double play. What a twin killing to end the inning. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Yandel Gustave. This guy can bring it velocity-wise.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
And welcome back. Top of the sixth inning. Here's the third baseman, Austin Riley. And a pitch. And a foul ball. Swings and misses, and now one away. Adam Duvall next up for the Braves. The pitch, and now 2-1. And he deals.
Ball three.
And a big swing and a miss. Now a blast to left center. Way back there. On its way. Out of here. Adam Duvall hits one out. And they add to their lead. It's 4-1.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
And next for Atlanta, Dansby Swanson. Right-handed reliever and delivers outside. Right-hander kicks, deals. Rolled over to third. Brasso picks it up, zips it to first, and Swanson is set down. Two outs, base is empty. Here's Dickerson now. Kicks and fires. That's inside. That one just misses.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
On the ground. And it goes just foul. Fouled off again. And it remains 3-2. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And that is that. Back here at the ballpark, now it's going to be Willie Adames. Popped in the air, left field. Ozuna settles under it and makes the catch. And there's one away. And now it's Christian Yelich.
Number 22, Christian Yelich.
The pitch. Up the middle. That's a base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Not a bad slider by any means. It was down and away, but an even better job to spoil that thing. And he let it travel, didn't try to hook it. Man, that's a really good approach. You can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
The lefty closing in on 100 pitches. And now it's Andrew McCutchen. Yelich goes. And safe. It's a stolen base. Ground ball, Austin Riley. Gets it to first. Got the out.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
The 1-1. And that one pulled foul. That missed it inside. It's 2-2. And a pitch. Swing and a high fly ball. Pretty well struck. Right field. Way back there. And out of here. They're going crazy in the dugout. And they're chipping away. It's 4-3. Two outs. Nobody on. Now it's Hunter Renfroe. To the right side. That's the inning. Jake Cousins will take over here, and he'll do his best to keep this close.
Number 54.
We go to the top of the seventh. Here's the catcher, Travis d'Arno. The pitch. Strike on the inside corner. That is strike two. Righty to the plate. And now 2-2. And there's a ball.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it. That's a nice at bat and a great take on 3-2. Probably could have gone either way in that spot around the knees.
Now in for the Braves, Eddie Rosario. And the right-hander deals. And it's fouled away. And the righty deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive. d'Arno aboard here at first with nobody out. And that's ball four.
Oh, you know this guy wants to swing it, but he's showing some good patience in this one. It's the second time he's taken ball four.
So now to the plate for Atlanta, Ozzie Albies. And the pitch. And it is 2-1.
Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
Pitch misses, and the count is 3-1. Left-hand batter waits, and it's ball four. He missed down low.
A real bad time for a walk. You're trailing in this ball game, trying to keep things close. They've been in a difficult spot, and things aren't getting any easier.
Bases loaded, nobody out. This one ripped, but foul to the right.
They need a strikeout, and you need a ball perhaps on the ground for a double play or get yourself a pop-up, something, but you've got to make some pitches. But if he can battle and get through this, he can earn some points.
Marcell Ozuna getting ready to hit. Grounded to third, could be two. Brasso over to second, on to Telez, and the double play ends the inning. Well, here's Darren O'Day to take over for the Braves. Right-hander who throws from the side, really almost down under. And he'll work on holding this lead. Back here at American Family Field, set for the last half of the seventh. And now the catcher comes up to hit. Omar Narvaez. The tying run at the plate. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul.
Pitcher having a pretty tough time getting that swing and miss. Third foul ball in a row.
The pitch.
They got 3-2.
Foul ball there. And a payoff pitch. That's ripped into the outfield. It's gone. A solo blast. And we have a tie ball game. It's 4-4. Lorenzo Cain up now for the Brewers. Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Up the middle, Albies. Out on a bang-bang play, but he made it close. Up now for Milwaukee, Michael Brasso. Tied at 4. And another ball.
2-1.
The 2-1. And there's a strike. And a swing and a miss. Now 2 out. So digging in, Colton Wong. This is a guy you got to keep an eye on when he digs in. Definitely been known to drop a drag bunt from time to time, and he's pretty good at it, Chris.
Yeah, and he creates a sense of urgency for the defense because of the speed, because of the ability to put down that bunt.
The kick, the 3-2. He swings and fouls one off. Three-two now. Stays alive. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2.
Some real good life going through the zone on that one.
Three-two. Oh, and that deflects off his glove. Throw on to Olsen, and we stay tied as the inning ends. So the Brewers bring on a new pitcher from the pen, Brent Suter.
Number 35, Brent Suter.
Welcome back. And now, Austin Riley. They say it went. Here comes a pitch. That's down and in. Late swing, fouled off. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Got him looking. And that's the first out. Adam Duvall next up for the Braves. He's already homered in this game. Here's a 1-1. And there's a foul ball. The wind and the pitch.
He really committed to that fastball up at the top of the zone. He knows that if he makes a mistake in the zone, it gets hit hard by a power guy like this. That's a nice miss right there.
The pitch. And now it's 3-2.
Still just the second batter of the inning, and on the mound, he's already thrown 13 pitches. They've got him working hard out there. And he reluctantly takes his walk.
And the batter will be the shortstop, Dansby Swanson. One away, tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. And here it comes. And down on strikes. And now two gone. Alex Dickerson next up for the Braves. He's already homered here in this one. And a 2-1 on the way. Ground ball right side. Wong over to pick it up. Tosses to first. And that is that. Jackson gets the call. He has a great slider with tons of movement.
Number 77, Luke Jackson.
Back here in Milwaukee, bottom of the eighth. And the batter now, Willie Adames. The wind of the pitch. That one lifted to left. Ozuna going back. Back some more. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's one away. So up next, Christian Yelich.
He's a big, strong guy. Can untie this game with one swing.
Kicks and deals. There's a line drive to left field. Can't get there. Base hit. And the go-ahead run into scoring position. One away.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. I love the approach he had right there with that pitch. Not trying to do too much, but still looking to drive it. And that's exactly what he's able to do into the opposite field gap for the double.
Here's Andrew McCutchen to hit. Next pitch is outside.
Well, Boog, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
Save! Three and two now. And fouled off.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
And a 3-2. And he walked him.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
Rowdy Tellez up now for the Brewers. One for two. Jackson checks on first. McCutchen gets back easily.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
Now front, pulls that one foul. Now it's 3-2. Two on, one out. Double play ball to second. Albies, off balance feed. There's one. Throw to first, but he beat it. Now it's Hunter Renfroe. The 1-1. Slider misses outside. And a pitch. That's a strike, and that is strike two. And a pitch. Montelez off of first with two away. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate. A game plan that he's sticking to. He's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
And a 1-1. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Telez rounds third, headed for the plate. The tag, and that's out number three, inning over. So Josh Hader gets the call to the mound, trying to protect this lead.
Number 71.
Back here at the ballpark, and here's the catcher, Travis Darno. And he deals. And that one fouled off.
Is there a little wrinkle to that?
I think there was.
Yeah. A little slider action.
And a ball and two strikes. And a swing and a miss. And the leadoff man retired here in the ninth. Now the leadoff spot for the Braves, Eddie Rosario. The pitch. Good eye in that spot.
I almost feel like he's frustrated a little bit. He wants to be challenged.
And now the lefty fouls one away, and now 3-2. One run game here in the top of the ninth.
Hanging in there pretty good against the lefty.
Left-hand hitter waits. And a foul ball, he stays alive.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Looking to get the tying run on base. Stays alive. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. And a swing and a miss. Braves down to their final out. And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Ozzie Albies. That one misses, and it's 2-1. Check swing, and he held up.
Big pitch coming right here. Last thing he wants to do is put the tying run on base, but he can't groove one either.
That's the third, and he picks it up, and he'll put it in his pocket. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So a ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss, and that's the ball game.
Well, this turned out to be an exciting, very well-played game. Always feels great when you can take the lead in the eighth at home. Come out in the ninth, crowd will be behind that pitcher as he tries to get those final three outs. Everybody goes home happy with a win like this.
Close one here today, and your final 5-4. They hang on to win it by a run. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.